You're watching the news on Bahrain International. I'm Hamid Shaban. Good evening. The National Security Advisor, Royal Guard Commander, Major General His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, held a video call with a Royal Guard team that reached the summit of Mount Everest. His Highness Sheikh Nasser exchanged congratulations with the Royal Guard team on the occasion of Eid al-Fitr, expressing pride in the outstanding efforts made by the Royal Guard team and their eagerness to achieve the desired goal, which affirms the capabilities of the Bahraini youth in overcoming difficulties and striving to raise the name and flag of the kingdom in all forms. His Highness noted that His Majesty the King's call to the Royal Guard team after the achievements gives the team the motive to continue to earn more achievements, praising the efforts of the Royal Guard team and its brave men. For their part, the Royal Guard team said that the call of His Majesty the King is a great incentive to continue making efforts to honor the kingdom, praising the role His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa throughout the realization of this difficult task.
Salaam alaikum. Jazakallah khair. Hayya Allah al-abtal. قواكم الله عز الله ما قصرتوا. لازم أول شيء أوصف لكم فرحة واعتزاز الجميع بما فيهم طبعا على رأسنا جميع سيدي جلالة الملك الله طول عمره. أتذكر رحت للملك الساعة 3 الفجر وجلست عنده وقلت له بس الربع على وشك وصول القمة، وكنت على اتصال مع الجماعة اللي في كامب 2 وكانوا يعطونا الأخبار أول بأول عن تحركاتكم وعن وصولكم. أول ما وصل أول شخص إلى قمة أفرست يانا الخبر، وكنا ننتظر منك بس توصل لترتب أمورك ثم تتصل بي. وتذكر هالاتصال اللي الحقيقة يوم شفت رقمك دريت أنكم حققتوا المهمة، وكلمتني عن طريق الساتلايت وعطيتك التلفون للملك ولا عرفت الملك أساساً إيش بيقول لكم. لكن تعرف اللحظة اللي أنا افتخرت فيها هو أن الملك الله طول عمره في ذكرى لكم يا شجعان، وأنكم أنتوا فخر لكل بحريني، وأنتوا عارفين يعني إحنا كلنا في هالوحدة ذي اللي مع بعض في الحرس الملكي، ربينا مع بعض ورحنا مع بعض إلى جميع الأخطار وقمنا بالمهمات مع بعض، وهذه أنتوا تمثلوننا كلنا. ونبذة بسيطة عن منهم جنود وضباط الحرس الملكي، فهذه شيء كبير احنا نعتز به ونفتخر به في وحدتنا، وان شاء الله ان جميع ضباط وافراد الوحدة متشوقين ينتظرون يشوفونكم ويسمعون منكم. اما للصورة الاكبر طبعا هذه تعكس تماما معدن البحريني اللي احنا دائما نكرر البحريني معدنه من ذهب. اللي أعرفه أن أنتوا عددكم كبير، رحتوا إلى القمة وصعدتوا يعني 12 شخص وباقي إن شاء الله كم شخص بعد يكملون المهمة. هذا شيء يعني الحقيقة يدل على قوتكم وجلدكم وشجاعتكم وصبركم. مريتوا في الأمور الكثيرة، تكلمنا قبل لا تمشون كان تذكرون قلت لكم وأنتوا تصعدون الجبل لا تفكرون في الوصول للقمة، قلت لكم فكروا شو بتقولون حق البحرينيين وللشباب بالأخص عن رحلتكم وعن تجربتكم وعن نجاحكم، لأن هذا اللي يهم، هذا اللي أنا أبي كل شاب وشابة يسمعون الطموح إلى وين يوصل، يوصل لأعلى القمم وأعلى، لو في قمة أعلى من هذه أعرف أنكم أنتوا راح تصعدونها. وأعرف بعزيمتكم وإصراركم، لو نزلتوا إلى بيس كامب وقلنا لكم ارجعوا والتقطوا صورة أحسن راح ترجعون، لأن سويتوها من قبل في مهام أكبر. يعني هذه ما هي إلا بس نبذة بسيطة للعالم عن من هو البحريني. فأنا كنت متابع معاكم أول بأول وأنتم عارفين الشيء، لكن هذه فرصة اليوم أني أشوفكم عقب ما أتميتوا هالمهمة وبارك لكم شخص شخص، وأتمنى الحقيقة أن نشوفكم في أسرع وقت. وأبي أسمع منكم أبو حمد، يعني أنت ولا أحد الشباب يعني علمونا، لأن ترى الكل متشوق يسمع منكم، وتعرفون هالاتصال هذا يعني راح نذيع ما في الاجتماعات الخاصة دي، هذه إن شاء الله راح يذاع. فأبيكم فعلا تطمنون كل محبينكم وكل من يعني سأل عنكم وتابعكم وفرح من فرحتنا أنه يسمع منكم كلمة كلمتين.
البداية بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نشكر جميع اللي معانا والطاقم الكل، الحمد لله ما قصر، والحمد لله كلنا كنا يد واحدة اشتغلنا عمل فريق، والحمد لله بفضل من الله وتوفيقه وصلنا ضمنه. واجهنا شوي تحديات صعبة لكن الحمد لله صلت، دام ان احنا مع بعض الحمد لله تيسرت منها. يعني الباب اكثر شيء، اكثر تحديات صعبة اللي واجهناها هي الباب، يعني انها هي من بداية لاخر يوم، من اول بداية المرحلة كان البرد، يعني وصلنا ليه يمكن درجة حرارة تحت 28، من عشرين تحت الصفر، لكن الحمد لله خابر كل واحد مع الثاني يشيل الثاني. في فترات كنا تعبنا فيها، في ناس طاحت، لكن اللي وياه الفريق اللي وياه الثاني كل واحد يسحب الثاني، والحمد لله وصلنا القمة ورفعنا العلم، وهاي المطلوب منا وحققناه بفضل من الله. الحمد لله رجعنا بالسلام.
الحمد لله انتم حققتوا هالمهمه ذي، لان عندكم علم غالي علينا جميع، وكانت مهمتكم انكم توصلون هالعلم هذه للقمه. وزود على هذا انتم روح واحد، انتم فريق واحد، انتم ربيتوا مع بعض. ولا تنسون انتم نجحتوا في السلم وفي الحرب، وكنتوا فريق واحد، وانتم مثل ما قال الرجال المجربين في الشده واللين. وهذا الرجل اللي فعلا الواحد يطوف كل الاختبارات، الحقيقة يعني مفخرة اني اشوفكم مرة ثانية واسمع من عنكم واشوفكم عن قرب الحين عقب ما اهتميتوا للمهمة، وبالذات يعني التحديات اللي عمركم ما مريتوا فيها. اعرف ان ما تمرنتوا قط في مرتفع ولا شفتوا هالبرودة هذه، ولكن يعني الحمد لله على كل حال. تعرفون أقول لكم شيء واحد، قال لي جلالة الملك الله طول عمره يوم أنتوا سافرتوا أول ما بديتوا الرحلة، أول ما بديتوا الهايك وصاعدين إلى بيس كامب، فقال لي الملك أحس فيك ثقة عالية وزايدة شوي، كأنك تتكلم من المهمة هذه سهلة. وهو المهمة مو بسهلة، المهمة صعبة، والله يتقبلهم ويغفر لهم إن شاء الله. ولكن اليوم احنا نتكلم، سمعنا خبر وفاة الأمريكي والسويسري عندكم وهو يحاول محاولتكم أنتم، فنعرف أن النسبة خطرة ونسبة النجاح خطرة ونسبة الموت بعيد عنكم لكم طولة العمر يعني كبيرة وخطرة، ولكن ثقتنا كانت فيكم أنتم، لأن ندري أن أنتوا ما مر امتحان ولا مر اختبار إلا وعديتوه وبكل شجاعة. وهذا كان فقط شيء بسيط ونبذة، مرة ثانية كنا نحاول نروي سيدي جلالة الملك رجالة، نروي سيدي جلالة الملك شجعانة، وأن مثلكم يعني يقتدى بهم الحقيقة. فبعد أبي أسأل كريس Phil and Rich, يعني I'm super proud of you all. Phil, I know you can hear me, but can you see me as well? Just about, okay, that's good. I'm anyways, two clicks to your left, you can see me directly. على العموم, I'm absolutely proud. I told to the team over here that we were confident, and His Majesty told me, why this overconfidence? I said, it's not overconfidence, it is that I'm sure of my men, I'm sure of you all, I'm sure that wherever you go, you will succeed. Wherever we go with a Bahraini flag, we will raise it up high. Whatever the mission is, if it was in peacetime or wartime, we will always remain as one team. We will always make sure that we make our country proud, our families, our beloved ones, and most of all, His Majesty. So I remember I was telling Mohammed bin Hamad that when he called me off the summit, and I was in touch with you, Chris, and he told me Mohammed have summited right now. I was waiting anxiously for this phone call, and I received the call. I gave it immediately to His Majesty. We were there sitting for an hour waiting for you to summit. So then, you know, His Majesty speaking out of his heart from a father to his sons was unbelievable moment for us all. And to send his message for peace, prosperity from on top of this peak is mostly needed. So well done, everyone. I have no doubt that this has been an incredible experience for us all, not just you guys. It was from logistical plan to going over there to summiting, to worrying back here at home, although you are all in one piece, alhamdulillah. And we hope we're gonna receive you soon and meet up and catch up and hopefully discuss it all. I know for one thing that is I'm 100% sure of, that you'll all say that it was worth it, because that moment is tough. It was pure hardship, but then this is what we are built for, to endure and to make sure that we really come back and send a message to everyone, to inspire everyone here in Bahrain to be just as good as you all. فقواكم الله يا اخوان.
His Majesty, the King's Representative for Humanitarian Work and Youth Affairs and Chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, said that the logo Victorious Bahrain has made many contributions to Bahrain through the French Paris FC team and the Second Division Football League. His Highness expressed his appreciation for the outstanding efforts made by the team in the league by achieving the fifth place. His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa praised Paris FC's victory over Chambly by 3-0 in the 38th week of the French League 2, indicating that the distinguished results of the teams reflect the keenness to make efforts and achieve good results. His Highness explained that the logo Victorious Bahrain is considered the distinguished mark in the French League, expressing pleasure to see the name of the kingdom in the European leagues, which is part of the contributions to achieving Bahrain's economic vision 2030. His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad expressed his appreciation for the outstanding efforts made by the players in their 3-0 victory over Chambly. The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Abdel Latif bin Rashid Al-Zayani, participated today in the virtual emergency meeting of the Executive Committee of the Organization of Islamic Cooperation, chaired by Saudi Foreign Minister Prince Faisal bin Farhan Al-Saud, with the participation of Arab foreign ministers and the Secretary General of the Organization of the Islamic Cooperation. During the meeting, the foreign minister delivered a speech in which he expressed sincere thanks to Saudi Arabia for its invitation to hold this emergency meeting to discuss the current developments in the Palestinian territories, expressing appreciation for the sincere efforts made by Saudi Arabia, Egypt, Jordan, and Tunisia in order to stop the escalation and reach a ceasefire between the Palestinians and the Israelis. He said that the continuation of this dangerous escalation threatens the lives of innocent civilians, exposes populated areas to great destruction, and may lead to more dangerous confrontations that threaten regional security and peace. The foreign minister said that the Kingdom of Bahrain reiterates its strong condemnation of the Israeli attacks on the city of Jerusalem and all the occupied Palestinian territories, and calls on the parties to stop the escalation in the Gaza Strip and the rest of the Palestinian territories. The minister added that the Kingdom of Bahrain affirms its support for the Egyptian initiative that seeks to achieve a truce between the Palestinian factions and the State of Israel, and to allow diplomatic efforts to reach a comprehensive ceasefire to prevent more casualties. Dr. Zayani affirmed that the Kingdom of Bahrain calls on the international community, the UN Security Council, and influential countries in the region to support the Egyptian initiative and urge the parties to accept it and start negotiations to reach a permanent ceasefire. He said that the Kingdom of Bahrain calls for concerted international efforts to achieve security, stability, and peace in this sensitive region, which has suffered for decades from insecurity, instability, and loss of hope, expressing the Kingdom's aspirations to work on a parallel path to initiate political talks to reach a political solution that achieves security and just peace based on the Palestinian people obtaining their legitimate rights to establish their independent state with East Jerusalem as its capital, in accordance with international legitimacy resolutions, the two-state solution, and the Arab Peace Initiative. The foreign minister affirmed that the Kingdom of Bahrain calls for unifying and intensifying diplomatic efforts to mobilize the necessary support for the Egyptian initiative and working for it to be backed by a Security Council resolution, urging all parties to welcome and accept the Egyptian initiative, including the State of Israel and the Palestinian factions in Gaza, and to continue efforts to achieve cooperation between the countries of the region to make them safe, stable, and prosperous for the benefit of all their people. The Minister of Works, Municipalities, Affairs and Urban Planning, Aslan bin Abdullah Khalaf, revealed 5 projects to beautify main intersections. Minister Khalaf pointed out that the 5 projects are to beautify the intersection of Salman Port, the intersection of Janabiyah, the intersection of Sheikh Isa Avenue with Sheikh Salman Avenue in Salmabad, the intersection of Sheikh Khalifa Avenue until Zalag Avenue, University of Bahrain, and the development of the Sar intersection. The minister also pointed out that these projects come within the national strategy for afforestation in accordance with the Supreme Council for the Environment to select trees suitable for the Bahrain climate, which shall contribute to improving the climate, reducing temperatures, and preserving the biological diversity of local plants. The head of Customs Affairs, Sheikh Ahmed bin Hamad Al Khalifa, made an inspection visit to the King Fahd Causeway in order to review all preparations for receiving travelers across the causeway starting from tomorrow, Monday, where plans and procedures were developed with the aim of increasing the maximum capacity of passport employees' performance to facilitate the flow of passengers, taking into consideration precautions and preventative measures recommended by the National Task Force team to combat the coronavirus. The King Fahd Causeway Authority Chief Executive Officer Imad Al-Mhaisin praised Saudi and Bahraini leadership for their keenness on citizens' and residents' health and safety, imposing mandatory precautionary measures to combat the pandemic and curb infections. He went on to state that the permission to leave Saudi Arabia would be restricted to vaccinated people and those who have recovered from, as shown in the application Tawakkalna, or a corona insurance certificate for those under the age of 18. As for passengers heading from Bahrain to Saudi Arabia, they'll be required to carry any of the health applications approved in the GCC, which confirm whether they are vaccinated or have recovered from the virus as shown in the application or approved applications in the GCC countries. Passengers can also show PCR certificates, which should not exceed a period of 72 hours from the time of taking the sample. Bahrain Souq Al-Qasriyya, one of the oldest parts of Muharraq's markets, welcomed visitors after years-long careful preservation. The Culture and Arts Director General at Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities, Sheikha Hala bint Mohammed Al-Khalifa, who toured the redeveloped Souq Al-Qasriyya in Muharraq, that Bahrain is committed to its vision of preserving and reviving traditional souqs and further by engaging with budding local designers. The souq played a fundamental role in shaping the pearling economy in Bahrain and now includes 5 historical buildings within the pearling path. The BACA said that the restored shops now sell fashion items and jewelry and has cafes while other stores selling branded items. Sheikha Hala bint Mohammed also inaugurated the Dar bin Harban. She affirmed that the opening of the new house came with the aim of enriching the intangible culture heritage as well as to introduce future generations and visitors to the kingdom of the rich and ancient culture heritage. She also noted that the Culture Authority is interested in folk arts by strengthening the infrastructure, incubating it, and by giving artistic groups the space to practice their creativity and activity in the original places that witnessed the emergence of these arts. The Dar project aims to rehabilitate this house as a center for folk art in the city of Muharraq, which works to revive and revitalize the folklore for which the region is famous, in addition to enhancing the status of the rich and diverse intangible heritage of the city. The national vaccination campaign continues to witness a wide turnout of citizens and residents. The Ministry of Health announced that 830,033 had taken the first dose of the vaccine, while 626,384 had taken the second. The ministry renewed its call for the community to commit to all precautionary measures and take the initiative to register for the coronavirus vaccination. Meanwhile, the Ministry of Health said today that the number of active coronavirus cases reached 15,821, with 1,298 recoveries, 1,619 registered new cases, and 5 new deaths. 549 of the new registered cases were expatriates, 1,061 were contacts of active cases, and 9 were travel-related. The ministry expresses its heartfelt condolences to the families of the deceased and urges everyone to comply with the guidelines issued by the National Task Force for Combating the Coronavirus.